just by myself. Jazz was even not named. It started off in brothels, bars, in the 1800s, near the end of the 1800s. And in those days, people just danced to piano playing, and they wanted something to dance with. So the people in the south of America started a new kind of music for dancing without a band. Mostly in those days were just pianos. Otherwise you'd be dancing to like Blue Danube or Over the Waves. But no, these people just wanted something more exciting. So I'm going to play for you a jazz tune, which is actually the root of all jazz, and it's called Ragtime. This particular piece is called Ragtime in Washington, D.C. And I will follow that with another short Ragtime, which you, most of you will recognize. Play a couple of songs under one subject, and this one I'm sure you know, all love songs, which are my favorite. A lot of love songs have the moon as the responsibility of all these great love affairs. So I'm going to start playing the first song that has the name of a moon to it. After that, I'll play another song that has moon to it too. I'm sure all of you must know many songs that involve the moon. Think of them. What? Blue Moon, the moon was yellow. Even Beethoven had Moonlight Sonata. Or, let me see. Name me a song with a moon, I'm sure, please. Let me hear.
Moon River,
it will be.
Thank you.
Do you know this moon song? One more moon song, which I think everyone knows, and it's very important. Of course, it's all about love too, like any other moon songs. I say important because this is among all the Chinese popular songs that were sung and played in this area, like Hong Kong and Macau. This particular one was among the first to be very popular in mainland China in the 1970s. So when that song went to China, everybody was singing. Thank you. this point, I would like to invite Yat, our great bass player, to join me, and Miss Fan Fan on the drums, and we'll play a little happy song, probably.